So I'll start my I'll start this session. So with the program 7, experiment number 7. Okay. So what's the experiment number 7? Exercise. Write a Java program to implement user-defined exception handling. Okay, a very simple concept. User-defined exception handling. In this problem statement, they have not mentioned anything particular. You have to write the program for like this application, negative amount. Okay. Age, and they have not mentioned any particular logic. Okay, so it is completely depends on your mind. You have to choose any one logic, okay, and make your program for user defined exception handling. Okay, a very simple concept. And you have already know about the exception handling mechanism in Java, because Java has its own exception handling mechanism, right? Just recall the session, the previous sessions, exception handling in Java. See, one hierarchy is there. So see, this is the hierarchy of exception handling mechanism in Java. The main class, which is a throwable, and the two classes, which extends a throwable class, a throwable interface, exceptions as well as error. Okay, so exception means a lot of predefined exceptions are already there in Java. IO exception, SQL exception, class not found exception, runtime exception. So under runtime exceptions, a number of exceptions are available. Arithmetic exception, null pointer exception. Okay, so a lot of exceptions are already handled by JVM. Then what's the use of handling such exceptions from the user side? Means based on applications, we have create our own exceptions. Okay, that's one point. And one more point, see here, one exception is here, arithmetic exception, right? So arithmetic exception, one, for example, divisible by zero. Okay, so you know about divisible by zero. So divisible by zero, definitely that concept which comes under arithmetic exception. Okay, so Java has its own mechanism to handle divisible by zero. Then what is you can give your own logic. You can make a program for divisible by zero by user handling exception. That is also available in Java. Okay, but what's the use of exception handling by user means? Okay, to see your program won't get be any stopped. Okay, you can continue your program. If JVM will take over the exception handling mechanism means, okay, so the, once the exception is raised, the program is actually quit. Okay, then at runtime, the exception may raised and display information which is displayed. Okay, so obviously your program is quit. Even though, but in user handling mechanism, so even though your exception is raised in particular code, okay, you can handle, and you won't be quit your program, and you can, your program will execute the remaining part of the code of your program. Okay, so that's the beauty of user defined exception handling, and also one of the beauty of Java, which is exception handling mechanism by JVM. Okay, so come to our program. So this is the program statement. Okay, write a Java program to implement user defined exception handling. So this is the program. Okay, it's a very simple concept, negative amount exception. Okay, so you know all about amount means it should be positive. That is, you know, if it is negative means it is illegal, right? So negative amount exception. So from the plenty of online resources you have come across, you can see some familiar things between the programs of user defined exception handling. So like it has its constructor, that is parameterized constructor with a string. Okay, so now so every program has a parameterized constructor with a string in user defined exception handling. Okay, then this is a predefined method, two string. Actually the logic of this method, which is convert anything into string. Okay, so this method, which is almost used all the user defined exception handling programs, you can see a lot of programs from the network resources. Okay, so some common things between all the programs. So I will start from the main. Okay, so this is our main. Okay, so what's our main class? My exception one. Okay, your user defined class, this is your main class. From the main, first scanner. Okay, so scanner, what's the use of scanner? You can get values from the console, right? So from the console or at runtime, I can enter any amount. Okay, I can enter an amount. That amount is received. Definitely, that amount here, the amount which is integer. Okay, so I have received the amount in the variable a, which is integer. So a, which is integer, so next int. Okay, so if a scanner means and the thing variable which is int means you have to use next int. If it is float means next float, next double. If it is string means next. A lot of predefined methods which is available in scanner class. Okay. Then some here. This is program which is about negative amount exception. So if the amount is negative means that is minus means, okay, less than zero means definitely you have to throw some message exception message. Okay, so the code here, if a less than zero means probably this is the code of throwing exception. So I will make this code in the try block. Okay, so try catch block, as usual, exception handling mechanism in Java. So within the try block, so here the code which is if a less than 0. Okay, so a means the amount you have entered from the console. If that amount which is less than 0, which is negative, okay, you have to throw exception. So try catch, see here a lot of exception handling mechanisms, a lot of keywords. See here that try catch, finally, throws. So okay, a lot of exception handling keywords which is available in Java. Okay, so throw. Okay, so throw means here if the amount is negative means one exception is throw by using throw keyword. See, kindly recall the syntax of throw. If you are using throw means you have, the next throw you have to come over with a new, okay, instantiate object. Okay, that's the syntax of throw. Throw means next, a new which is added. So new means obviously in Java new, which is the instantiation purpose, right, object. So negative amount exception, new negative amount exception of invalid amount. What's the meaning of this statement? Actually, negative amount exception, which is the class. Okay, see here, this is the class that is use the defined exception handling class, negative amount exception. Okay, here from, so here you are creating object for the class negative amount exception. Okay, and with the parameter invalid amount. Okay, so which means if there are any constructor that is parameterized string constructor which is available in the class means, okay, that constructor has received a message that invalid amount. Okay, so this is the this is the argument which is passed here. So next, so on encountering this line, okay, obviously the control will come over here. So in the code throw, you are creating the object for the class negative amount exception. Okay, so the message, the variable message which received the message invalid amount. Okay, so invalid amount, that message is saved here. See here, one code is here, this dot message equal to message, right? This dot message equal to message, this message. Okay, so this message which is about this. Okay, so negative amount exception. Okay, and this dot message which is about this one. Okay, a same variable which is used for a different purpose. And how can you differentiate that variable? This dot message means MSG, that variable which belongs to the class negative amount exception. Okay, the scope of this message within whole class. Okay, here this message, string MSG. Okay, so this message which is about local variable. Okay, so this is just local variable, and scope which is within the negative amount exception. Okay, the scope of this message which is within the method. negative amount exception. Here, this message which is about class scope, which is the class. Okay, so overall the class, the scope which has message. Okay, so this is actually, this is the role of this. Actually, in Java, the role of keyword this has two purpose. The one of the purpose which is the differentiate instance variable. Okay, this is the instance variable. Differentiate instance variable so from the local variable. Okay, some cases you are using a same name for instance variable as well as local variable for that purpose. For this keyword, which is used to differentiate the instance variable from the local variable. Okay, so so the messages are received, the message invalid amount. Okay, and using this to string method, okay, it returns a message. It returns message that is invalid amount. Okay, it returns, okay, from the class negative amount exception. So from this string to string method, this class returns something. Okay, that is invalid amount. It returns invalid amount, which is received by here catch. Okay, this is received by catch here and print here. Okay, so come to the Eclipse. Text loading. Okay. So this is our program. Okay. Here I import one thing because you are using scanner. Okay, scanner, which is the class scanner, which is available in the utility package. Okay. So just I import here. So the full code. So just run the program. Actually, it is running the last program, but our program is in the name my exception one. Okay, so this is our program my exception one. Okay, so I have created all the programs in the project CS8383. Just I'm using the default package only. Okay, you can use the separate package, but I'm using all this in the default package. So my exception, this is our program. So right click. It will take time. So because a lot of software is dumped into the system. Sorry, actually this program, which is our program only, enter amount. Okay, so I just enter first positive value, amount deposited. Okay, amount deposited, which is print over here. Okay, because no any exception which is raised. Once again I have see run my exception one. It's our program only. So once again I have run the program. So just enter the negative value, minus 50. Okay, invalid amount. Okay, so this is the example of how to handle exception by user. Okay, user handling exception or user defined exception. So one program. Next, you can use any other logic. Okay, second program. See, this is this program which is also I have taken from the Anna University your lab set university questions. Okay, write a Java program to implement user defined exception handling. Okay, but here they have given your logic. Okay, display the result for the following input. A equal to 0, B equal to 0. Perform C equal to A divisible by 0. Definitely, so this is the program of divisible by 0. Okay, but you are performing program as user defined exception handling. Okay, so in Java, divisible by 0 means that logic, that program, that exception comes under arithmetic exception. Okay, if you are not handling the exception, means automatically JVM take over the part. Okay, at any particular code, if you are trying to divide any value with 0, means automatically another exception is raised and your program is quit and exception message which is displayed in your window. Okay, so JVM take over the part, but here for the same logic divisible by 0, you are going to create a logic for use, that is user defined exception handling. Okay, you are going to, so in this program you are going to handle the divisible by 0 by your own logic. So this is the program. See, here from this come again starts with the main method. So this is the main. So from the console you have received the value A and B. Okay, receive the value A. Actually this is not enter amount, this is enter A and B. Okay, so receive the value A and B. So in the try block, this is the code where we expect to raise some exception, right? So that code which is available in try catch block. So if B equal to 0 means you have to throw it, exception. So in throw means obviously you have to create an instantiation. We start the instantiation here. I'm creating the object for the class division by 0, and a message exception called division by 0. Okay, so sounds this code will be implemented automatically. The control will come over here and the string 2, okay, the string 2 here which is received the message exception called divisible by 0, and this is which is saved into the instance variable string 1. Okay, and from using the method to string method, a default method, a predefined method, okay, to string. So I'm not writing this to string, actually this is the predefined method. Okay, it's not my own method, which returns the value, that value which is received by this catch block. Okay, with the message exception called divisible by 0. Okay, so this is the program for handling division by 0 using user exception handling mechanism. So I will have this program the name my exception 2. So enter A and B value. Okay, so if I first A 5 then B 0 means exception caught division by 0. Okay, the exception is caught. If once again I have run the program and 10 I have given 5 means the result 2 is displayed. Okay, this code is displayed. So for the program you can use either my exception 1 or my exception 2. Okay, so these two programs are both are comes to the category of user defined exception handling. Okay, next write two Java programs, one implementing arithmetic exception and the other implementing array index out of bound exception. Okay, so this program also I have taken up from the question set. Arithmetic exception, you have to write two separate programs for arithmetic exception and array index out of bound exception. For arithmetic exception, okay, here I am choosing the same thing, division by 0. Okay, so this program actually this is the program which is not comes under user defined exception handling. Okay, so for user defined exception handling means for exercise number 7, so either you can use this program, okay, the first program, or you can use the second program. Okay, So this is the program for, you have to give an example for arithmetic exception as well as array index out of bound exception. So arithmetic exception, the same program, division by zero. Okay. So I will start over here from the main. Okay. From the console, like I have received A and B. Okay. And within the try block, actually result equal to A division by zero. This is the code where possibility of raised some exception. Okay, so that code should be presented within the try. Then in this is the for a result displaying the result, and this is the for catch the arithmetic exception. I'm not using any user defined exception. Already predefined exception is that arithmetic exception, the same exception I have used here. Okay, so this is not an example for user defined exception. A predefined exception, arithmetic exception, which is available so in the class throw exception class. Okay, so a simple code. Okay, from the console you are receiving two values. If the value of B, which is 0, means exception erased. Okay, and see here one thing, E dot B, which is the object of the class arithmetic exception. We are creating object of the class for arithmetic exception. And here see print stack trace. Okay, so actually this is also a predefined method to display the error message at your console. Okay, for that purpose you are using print stack trace in your exception handling mechanism program. So this is the program, division by zero. Okay, so I'll just run the program. So I'm giving just to integer means there is no any exception is raised. Okay, I'm giving the value. Okay, see, this is the message printed by the print stack trace. Okay, so this is the exception which is available in arithmetic exception. Okay, those exceptions are available in the language package. Okay, so in var the exception is raised, code number 70. Okay, the code number 70, the exception is raised. Okay, so once again I have mentioned here, this is not a user defined handling mechanism. I am just using the predefined mechanism, arithmetic exception. Okay, next example for array index out of bound exception. Okay, array index out of bound exception. From that name you can guess what do you mean by array index out of bound. Okay, so out of bound means if your array has the size only 3, means you are, if you are trying to access the index value 4, means definitely that it will raise the array error exception. Okay, so 4 means here only 3 spaces, it starts index 0, 1, 2. Okay, so these indexes are only available. If you are trying to access values from 4, means definitely it will raise exception. That is array index out of bound exception. That exception which is also a predefined exception. Okay, so from the main, adjust from the console, you have to enter the size of the array. Based on the array, you have to fill the value. Okay, you have to fill some value, and in the try block, see, in the try block here, after filling the array, just one print statement, that is enter array index to get value. Okay, enter array index to get value. If your array size 3, means what are all the possible index? 0, 1, 2. Okay, these are all the possible index for the array size 3, right? If you are trying to access 3 and 4 index, means that definitely that code will raise the exception, so that only that code is available in try block. Okay, so anyone is unmute your mic, is there any doubt? Okay, so this code is probably throwing an exception, probably raises some exception from this code, that then only you can place the code within the try. So the name of the exception, which is the array index out of bound exception. Okay, we are printing here we are printing the statement, print statement. Okay, exception error message using print stack trace. sorry, index out of bound exception. See, this is the program. Just run the program. Just enter the size of the array, which is 3. Okay, enter some integer value for index 0 and enter some integer value for index 1 and enter some integer value for index 2. Okay, if I am I have entered index number 4 means. Okay, enter array index to get the best. Here the size of array which is 3, so what are all the indexes are possible? 0, 1, 2, but here I am entered 4. Okay, what will happen? See, this is the error message. Okay, the error which is array index out of bound exception, the package which is lang and where it is raised number 18. Okay. See, one more thing which is displayed end of the program, right? One more thing which is printed here, end of the program. Okay, see, what's the use of to add those statements? First I will eliminate the try block. Okay, just I will remove the try as well as sorry. Just command those things. Okay. I just command the try and catch. So let me check what will happen. So I have command all the try catch statements. Okay. So after the received index, this statement is printed here. Okay. So save the program and once again run the program. Enter the size of the array only 2. So for index 0, 10, 20. If I am entering here 3 means, see, the same message is also printed because that is the thing, the Java has a mechanism. It's the exception handling mechanism. So automatically the message is printed over here. Okay. But what's the code? End of the program. The remaining section of the program is not yet executed, right? So that is why you are using the try block, try and catch block here. Okay. So if you are handling the exception, it may be user defined or it may be a predefined exception. If you are using try catch block, means the remaining part of the code should be executed. Okay. So I will remove the command. Just run again the program. Enter the size of the array 2, 10, 20. Here 4 means. See, the end of the program. The statement is printed. Okay. So that's the use of a try catch block. That's the use of handling mechanism. Okay. So almost exercise number 7, which is almost over. Okay. So for exercise number 7, this is your exercise number 7, write a Java program to implement user-defined exception handling. For this, you can use either first program. So either first program, this program which is about negative amount exception, and you can use either the second program which is about division by zero exception. Okay. So exercise number 7, it is over. Next, exercise number 8. This is also a very simple concept. Write a Java program that reads a file name from the user. Okay, that reads a file name, file concept. Okay, file handling mechanism. File name from the user displays information about whether the file exists. Okay, whether the file is readable or writable, the type of file, and the length of the file in bytes. Okay, so these all information you should display. Okay, from this program. And the code of this program, exercise number 8, which is about file handling mechanism. Okay, so this this is the concept of file handling. So this is the program. Okay, from the console I just enter the name of the file. Okay, so this statement, which is about to open the file. Okay, next, some informations are displayed over here. This statement, which is about the name of the file, we are all the methods are a predefined method. Okay, get name used to get the name of the file, get path used to get the name of the path. Okay, get parent, which is used if any parent which is available, then which is used to get the parent of the file. This is for file exist, whether the file is exist or not. Okay, if the file is not existing, then this statement is print over here. And whether the file is readable, whether the file, if it is not, means the file cannot be read. Okay, so see the main thing here, which is that these are all the main parts for the program. Predefined methods, can read, can write, is directory, if it has any directory, means is directory. Okay, get parent, get path, get name. Okay, so these are all the things you should remember from this program. Okay, next, this is the program. So this is the program. If you enter the file names, I have already one file is created here, version 1. Okay. Okay, that file which is already created. How to create the file? The same thing. Here file. Okay. This is for creating the file in Eclipse. So I just enter the version 1. So all those informations are displayed here. No parent. Actually, the display version 1 which is not exist. So in the last time I have run the program, it will display the information if the file is exist only. Okay, but now displays the file does not exist. Okay, let me try in your system. Okay. So this is the program which is about exception file handling. Okay, file handling is exercise number 8. So exercise number 7 as well as exercise number 8, both are over. So we post the programs in your WhatsApp group. Okay, use your program. And in your exams classroom, I think on quizzes poster, okay, Viva, for Viva 2, one more quizzes poster for today's session. And the due time for the Viva, which is 3:30 p.m. of for today, okay. So we post all the programs in your WhatsApp group. Try to run the program. You have to run the program. Because this is not a theory session. So I just quit this session. Okay, so meet again you from the next session number 4. So I will post the program into your group. Just kindly check.